Welcome to another edition of Highway 89, BYU Radio's live music show. Tonight with a live audience. Hi, live audience. I'm Tim Slover, and for this program, the highway turns into a rutted midnight cemetery road to passion, obsession, dark deeds, bad intentions, and love beyond the grave. In studio with us are the creators and cast of the one, the only, the amazing, the heartwarming and heartbreaking Deep Love, a ghostly folk opera. Rock operas were born as the rock and roll 1960s gave way to the glam 1970s. Eschewing as inadequately expressive the three-minute pop song, bands such as Yes and Jethro Tull began weaving story and song in album length and sometimes double and triple album length, sung through extravaganzas. Musicologists marked the beginning of the true rock opera with The Who's release in 1969 of Tommy, a story about it's told in thematically linked rock songs about a deaf, dumb, and blind pinball wizard. The next year saw two artists from the world of theater, Andrew Lloyd Webber and Tim Rice, release Jesus Christ Superstar to acclaim and controversy. And after that, it was on, as talented artists embraced the potent combination of rock and theater. The Kinks in Arthur, or The Decline and Fall of the British Empire, Pink Floyd in The Wall, Genesis in The Lamb Lies Down on Broadway, Frank Zappa in Joe's Garage, and David Bowie in The Rise and Fall of Ziggy Stardust and the Spiders from Mars, about a benevolent alien who just wants to free us earthlings from being too dull. All of which leads us to right now, in this studio, and Deep Love, a grassroots cousin of the rock operas which preceded it. Ryan Hayes and Garrett Sherwood describe the scoring of this opera as music that blends traditional folk instruments and melodies with bluesy American rock. All I know is I'm excited because I see a lot of instruments I like in the room. Deep Love, a ghostly folk opera, was first performed by a handful of people in the living room of a friend. I think that friend is here with us tonight, and has now grown and matured into an annual full-scale multi-city event featuring an ensemble of 25 people. It's the sort of musical tale which grew in the telling, and fans come back each year to see what's new. This year, that includes two new female voices, rising stars Savannah Berry and Amy Whitcomb. The cast of Deep Love will perform an abbreviated acoustic version of the opera, complete with narration, a little later in the program. But first, let's talk with one of the two creators of Deep Love, Mr. Garrett Sherwood. Welcome, Garrett.
Thank you very much, Tim.
You're a spoken word poet who's won poetry slam competitions in Chicago, where you're from, I think.
Yeah, that's correct.
Also, you've won in Idaho and California. Now you're a rock opera librettist. We'll get to that second part in a minute. But about your poetry, you say that you like to write about things that go boom. What do you mean by that?
I guess it's just my way of saying I like to be able to move people. And being able to do it just with words is something that's truly amazing, which is what drew me to poetry.
Well, you're originally from the Chicago area.
That's true.
So how'd you end up in Rexburg, Idaho, rooming with Ryan Hayes and writing a rock opera?
Well, I came there for school, as did he. We were both students at BYU Idaho, and music had been a passion since I was young. We met each other at a school event where we were both playing songs in our respective bands. My roots are more kind of blues. He is more folk. Old-timey folk, but we both gained an instant respect for each other's work, for what we did. We became friends through music. A little bit after that, we decided to go on a road trip together. This was his idea. I was still in school at the time. He told me, he said, "Hey, Garrett, let's just go play on street corners and play our songs and see what happens." And so we did, all up and down the West Coast. After that, we were even better friends. We became roommates. And it was in a January in Rexburg, Idaho. If anybody has ever been in Rexburg in January, there's not much to do except stay inside. So we stayed inside and we said, let's do something cool. Let's have some fun. And we started to write this show.
You know, you've also published a book of poetry.
Yeah.
It's a truly great title, Trust Falls into Wet Cement.
Thank you.
I love the cat on the cover, by
Thank
the way.
You.
There's a lot of graveyard images in the poetry in that book. Here's one of my favorite of your vivid lines. I made headstones from my baby teeth. Mm-hmm. That's from a poem called Old Mr. Blowtorch Gunshy. Yeah. How much did thinking about baby teeth coming into headstones makes it into deep love?
Well, I think it's a matter of using symbolism, similar symbolism in two different genres. A gravestone or a headstone is a powerful symbol of both life and death. So I use it in the poetry for that. It's a symbol of an expression I was trying to get out there. We wrote this rock opera to express a lot of feelings about love and life and death. And the graveyard just seemed like kind of the best fit for that type of situation, oddly enough. And it works really well, having a love story set in a graveyard and in that scene of all that symbolism, all those headstones, and it's beautiful.
Do you want to give us a one-sentence summary of the story, or is that even possible? I'm putting you on the spot here just a little bit.
Of deep love?
Yeah.
Whoa. One sentence is hard.
Two sentences. A compound sentence.
It's the story of a ghost and his still living love and her attempts to find new love and new life in such a dark place.
That is beautifully said. That is beautifully stated. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thanks, Garrett. We're going to talk now to the other co-creator, Ryan Hayes.
Well, this is a treat.
It's a treat for me.
I didn't know you were going to pull me up here. Here we go.
I want to go a little further, if I can, just into the synopsis. This is what the website says. Deep love is a glimpse at life through the eyes of a young widow as she struggles to meet the demands of her deceased husband's undying love. That's what Garrett eloquently said to us. So here's my question. Sometimes undying love can be a bit of a trial?
It sure can.
Because, you think of undying love as a good thing.
It's true. However, in the end, you will understand what I mean by deep love.
Okay. Because,
yeah.
It's a good hook.
Yeah.
I understand you spread the good news of deep love by skateboard in Rexburg, Idaho, a couple of years ago. What was that like?
Hey, not just a couple of years ago. I am an avid skateboarder and an avid missionary for deep love and my music in general.
And they went together.
Oh, yes. I've found a way to combine everything that I do. I'm actually a geologist by trade.
I read that.
And I've been able to incorporate rock into my music as well.
I was really proud of myself for not making that pun, but I'm glad one of us did now.
It had to happen.
Tell us a little bit about casting this year's performances, especially bringing in Savannah Berry and Amy Whitcomb.
Well, not many people know this, but John Lewis and I went on TV as an incognito duo called Midas Whale. And we did this with the sole intention of talking about the show to a lot of important people and all the while looking for star talent that we might be able to incorporate into the show. And I remember hearing Savannah, or hearing lots of people on the show sing, and thinking specifically of Savannah and Amy, just in terms of how great, at how perfect they are for the roles in this show. One of them is very meek and very innocent, while the other one is very rough and very, how would you describe yourself, Amy?
Fierce.
So you're talking about the characters, not the singers, right?
No, they're both. Honestly, they fit the mold so well, you wouldn't even believe it.
Okay, I'm gonna talk about that, I'm gonna think about it. I'm not gonna talk about it, but as Ryan's going back to his chair so that we can get an extended excerpt from this wonderful opera. Let me just tell you that the characters in the story, Ryan was starting to tell us about this. Constance is played by Savannah Berry. Florence, played by Amy Whitcomb. Old Bones is played by John Peter Lewis. We'll get to hear from all of those people in interview in a little while. And Friedrich, played by Garrett Sherwood. So, a specially excerpts version with narration of Ryan Hayes's and Garrett Sherwood's Deep Love, a ghostly folk opera.
Thank you.
The setting for tonight's show is a moonlit cemetery, if you can just kind of close your eyes and imagine that with me. However, if you're driving on the freeway, don't close your eyes and imagine that. Where a grieving ghost named Old Bones sings of his undying love.
You know my love for you was deep and silent as the peace I keep beneath the world of broken dreams. I reach for you, bereaving and unseen, deep beneath. The tangled roots, our colors lie asleep. The bonds of love are strong enough to keep you in my reach. Your love has rendered me a slave to keep a promise well beyond the grave. A riddle to my love would speak, deciphered by the tears you weep. The tale of lovers torn by grief, and in the end you'll see why love is deep.
And here we see Constance, our heroine and centerpiece of the show, enter the scene. She's a beautiful and tender young girl who has come to the graveside to mourn her true love, Old Bones. Hearing her cries, Old Bones reaffirms his vows and affection and promises to watch over Constance, though she cannot see or hear him.
Look at me so cold, with nothing left, afraid of life, afraid of death. I feel the shroud of night repose, and in my cell the cold wind blows. Chains off of me.
All through the night I hear you cry. All through the day I hear you pray. All through I'll dry your tears till life is through. I'll be by your side watching over you. So promise me never to cry. I'll be here all through the night. You may never see me, but darling, believe me, I'm with you. Haze the sunshine, darling. Can you see I'm starving
One day, a spry and stylish young man named Friedrich comes into Constance's life. At first, she resists his advances, but by and by, she feels the old revitalizing sensation of puppy love, begins to develop happiness and let it into her life again. And they begin to fall in love.
There's something about today. I think there may be something about this place. All the lonesomeness I felt, it falls away when I feel that stranger's gaze upon my face. What a difference a moment makes. In the moment that you came, my past, it falls away. Now I'm clinging to the ground as my world turns upside down. In the moment that you say to me your name, I was lost but now I'm found.
Deep in the shadows of Friedrich's murky past lurks Florence, one of his jealous and obsessive ex-lovers. She's been following Friedrich's every move and confronts him about Constance, his new young catch. She asserts that only she knows who Friedrich truly is and insists that he stop lying for the sake of love.
I waited all the night, but my bed stayed cold. I see through all your lies. I'm not so easily fooled. The night has changed, but I know you're still.
Friedrich knows that his past is full of dark deeds, but his search for inner peace has been earnest. He's finally found a constant in his life, and she makes him actually want to be a better person. So he repents of his past life and moves along in true belief that by centering his life around Constance, his soul would be safely reclaimed. They fall deeper in love, and Friedrich proposes that they be together forever.
Fits perfectly in mine, and time
will barely pass as I find your lips flush against mine, and I'm much more yours than mine.